pre-implantation genetic diagnosis helps ensure healthier and more successful IVF pregnancies by looking for genetic defects in embryos. Now, there are actually two different genetic testing procedures used, PGD and PGS. Although the two terms are sometimes used interchangeably, they are different. PGS is the screening of an IVF-created embryo for the correct number of chromosomes. Typically, humans have 23 pairs of chromosomes for a total of 46. But people with Down syndrome, for instance, have an extra chromosome 21. PGS can identify which embryos have Down syndrome and other similar disorders. Chromosomal abnormalities are present in about 50% of IVF-created embryos, and such abnormalities account for about 70% of early miscarriages. Using PGS to identify which embryos are chromosomally normal can reduce the chances of IVF failure or early miscarriage, leading to higher pregnancy success rates. PGD, on the other hand, examines an IVF-created embryo for a specific genetic defect. In cases where one or both of potential parents are known to be a carrier for genetic disorder, PGD tests the embryo for that disorder. Couples can then make a decision on whether they want to implant that embryo or to use another embryo which is free of genetic defects. In general, PGS and PGD are excellent choices for anyone going through IVF who is 35 or older, has experienced recurrent miscarriages or failed multiple fertility treatments, or who is a known genetic carrier of a defect or chromosomal disorder. PGD costs on average $3,200, but it's important to remember that's always in addition to the cost of an IVF cycle, which is frequently more than $12,000, as well as any additional procedures such as ICSI. Talk to your fertility doctor if you think PGD might be right for you.